This video series is to introduce website development to beginners who don't know anything about making websites. If this particular video seems too easy, click the first link in the description to go to the next one. The methods in this video may not be the best, but I'll try to explain them as best as I can. Building a website isn't difficult, it just takes some time. Everything I use in this series to make a website will be free, and I'll provide the links to all the software and resources. First, you should understand that websites are simple files on a computer that web browsers open and display what is written in certain languages. Because they are simply files with text in them, you can make them in programs like Notepad. However, to make it easier on your workflow, we'll be using some free software to get started. Websites can be made using software known as What You See Is What You Get. This includes website building services and software like Squarespace and Adobe Dreamweaver. Dreamweaver has a visual editor, which is the What You See Is What You Get part, and also a code view. This can be useful, but it can be a crutch to rely on the visual editor, and often won't display it accurately. I find it best to write code and then view it in the internet browser where it will be seen by everyone else. Most developers do this. The software I'll be writing in is called Sublime Text. There's a link below this video. The browser I'll be using is Google Chrome. There are many different languages out there for web development. They can all be used together, and browsers that most people use are able to read common languages. Languages are used together to add fluency, functionality, and efficiency to a website. I'll briefly explain some of the common languages. Hypertext Markup Language, or HTML, is the fundamental language that makes up all websites. When websites first began to be developed, websites were mostly coded only with this language. Now that some websites have thousands of pages, a simple redesign to one page would require changing every page. Luckily, other languages allow us to simplify this. While HTML is about building a website's skeleton and body, JavaScript is all about functionality. With it, you can create functions that make the web experience more interactive. Cascading style sheets, or CSS, is what makes websites look how they do. It's what differentiates one site from another. CSS is how you style a website to look the way you want it to look. Without CSS, most websites would look like a page with words written on it. Each language has its own file extension. For example, if you made a file called test using HTML, the file name would be test.html. If you use CSS, it would be test.css, and so on. You can make these files using any word processor, but there are specific software made for development. There will always be different software for this, as the software for anything else changes, and it will be up to you to choose one that suits your taste. A popular one right now, and the one I'll be using, is Sublime Text. You can download this software using the on-screen link or the link in the description. After you've downloaded the software, click on the annotation to be taken to the next video.